reflecting off the pictures in the background.
Yeah.
To make it less,
You mean the orange spot or just in general?
I like the orange spot. You want me to move
it? No. I've always kind of liked
because it. Because it makes the background less.
Now that we're recording, people can hear all our terrible reasonings for why we allow lighting that they don't like to be in our show.
This is the best.
Is it the best, or have we just been worn down to the point where it's like, fuck it, go with anything?
This is maximum effort.
I do think the enjoy it. I do think the are we? Do we have sound?
Look, I got my thing on, and it's making it.
Why do you wear a bulletproof vest under every shirt you wear?
It's not a bulletproof
vest. Tap it again. It sounds like a bulletproof vest.
It's yeah, that was. It's my back brace.
Why is it on your belly, though? I don't get it.
It's up here.
But is it supporting your belly?
Huh?
I'm just kidding. What? Your brain doesn't work fast enough for my dad jokes?
To support my back. Hold on.
So first of all, I want to play. So we should say, welcome to another Filmmaking Friday. Your weekly.
Oh, I thought we just didn't bother with
your
that.
Weekly pep talk, filmmaking pep talk, that you needed from these
that
one
you didn't know you needed
that you didn't know you needed from this 1.5 people sitting in front of you, fussing.
Why did you stop? Finish the sentence. Fussing.
Fussing at me.
At you?
Yeah, you fuss.
You're fussing about me, and I'm fussing at you.
I remembered something. Now that we're like getting close to our 100th episode, and in the feed here, you haven't heard our 100th episode yet. We have recorded it,
yeah, but we did that like months ago.
Don't pull back the curtain, you son of a bitch. Well, yes, the way production works, you get a lot of things done and edited so that you can release them and not have to scramble to get a show made every... It's taken us 6 years to get to that point.
Yeah.
Where we have multiple episodes. But I was... Once we got into the 100th realm, I was thinking about some of our older episodes. So I just went back and listened to the intros of a couple of them. And we sounded like we were having so much fun back then. Now I don't know if we're having as much fun as we were. We're way too serious now.
What I hear when you play it is how fake I am and how hard I'm trying to not be my normal asshole self. And I'm trying to force it. So I'm trying to do voices. And what stupid voice can I do? So that
do you remember...
I can make him laugh and then he can make me laugh. And, cause I was just... I don't know if you remember, but I was like, out of what, 30, 40 minutes away? You had to go get me.
Oh, I remember.
So it's like an hour...
How could I forget?
It's like an hour and a half just to
and then,
get here.
And then we'd get here and then you'd start trying to get ready.
And I'm miserable when I get here. Because... pain, whatever.
Yeah, but Brad.
Sadness.
But Brad, you seem the same to me.
you don't remember very well. Then,
I remember.
I'd be sitting there going, like, just not even saying anything, barely verbal.
Roll back any of our 100 episodes. What are you doing most of the time? You're just sitting there not saying anything. And now we have video to prove it. You sit there almost angrily like, why am I doing this?
Yeah. I'm never ready.
You're never ready. No, but what I'm saying is...
I just want to finish my point that it's maximum... It was like maximum effort and maximum fakeness to be... That and you're like, oh, it was so fun. I wish we could go back to that. And I'm like, I was so miserable. Yeah. It's so fake.
I guess what I'm saying is I wish we could go back to when you tried
harder
to make people around you happy. Because now I don't get any of that, and it's a fucking shit show. I don't get, at least back then, I can at least look back fondly and think, Brad was even trying. Look at him. 5 years ago, Brad tried to put forth an effort to make sure people enjoyed being around him. Now, none of that.
But aren't
Don't
we
be that.
In reality TV days? Don't they want realism, right?
Look. No.
Are you saying they would rather me go back to doing stupid voices?
Just do the Cartman voice.
Yeah, you piss me off.
That's so much better. That's so much better.
Doing shows piss me off. Fuck you, Beckman.
Doing shows piss me off. But I say all of that, and I have a surprise for you, because you have not heard this for 6 years. I guarantee it.
Yeah, I don't listen to any of them.
No, you don't. Because you don't care to listen to yourself.
That's not true.
I cleaned it up with you don't care to listen to yourself.
I was there when it happened. I'm good. I don't need to hear it again.
Do you remember this?
I know it. Yo, word to your mother.
Okay. Your word to your mother. That's the whitest version of
my name is Brad Star. Just take a listen to me, because I'm a Brad Star rapping as a cool MC.
Oh, man.
I got skills, bro.
Okay. That's not what I was trying to play you.
That's it. What you don't know is that everything I did on those episodes was stuff that I had backlogged, like, this is funny, that's funny, this is funny, and then I just did them all on the show, and then I ran out. So if you want to know why we're not doing that anymore, I ran out of all of my shit.
Okay, this is what I wanted to play you.
Alright, I'll talk to you guys later.
Alright,
see
you.
Bye.
Who is
that?
Oh.
Professionally.
Copyright.
Professionally.
Professionally
make a theme song for us, and here it is. You
want to
hear it?
Yeah, totally. The film Every Podcast is a production of Broken Sons. Said film's cable was created and is produced by Michael McMahon and Ben Jensen. The film Every Podcast, The film Every Podcast is made for people!
It's made for people!
The funny thing is Chris is trying to...
Yes.
Hold on.
That was another thing in my repertoire.
It's made for people. But listen to how much fun we were having. You haven't rapped a thing in 6 years.
You did an app, and you just took us doing it.
Yeah, but it was
fun. I'm going to destroy all the illusion.
No, I know. We didn't produce that, but it was.
That was a cool app, though.
Yeah. Yeah. The good old days.
Yeah.
I just thought that was
funny.
I love that.
Phil Hartman, man. My eyes are...
You're getting emotional about licking. Phil Hartman?
It's typical me getting ready for a show where my entire body shuts down. And it rejects the notion of wanting to be productive at all. So, like, allergies, whatever. Just eyes won't stop doing stuff. So, yeah, there we go.
I'm looking at you. And
you
I
got
still,
it.
I still think... You got
full,
it.
Full blown.
I still think you're out of focus.
Forward, back? What the fuck do you want me to do? I think you're being nitpicky.
Well, that's my job. That's good directing.
Good directing.
That's good directing.
All I see is all the wrinkles because the...
By now, by this point in time in the wrinkly. In
all
the
right,
feed. Oh yeah, this is wrinkly. That's, I pulled this out of them.
You're getting wrinkles, people.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't unwrinkle things. It's not part of my look. You know how people, you know how my students are always like, Beckemeyer, You always look exactly alike. I'm like, yeah, that's part of my design. I can get up and walk out of the house in 15 minutes at 5:30 in the morning. I don't have to iron the night before, throw something in the dryer, or do anything like that.
Yeah.
I started shaving my head like a decade ago, so I had to stop brushing my hair, getting a haircut every 2 weeks, all that.
Oh my God.
Human being shit that's like, it doesn't fucking matter.
Yeah.
And all I want to do is just streamlining your life.
Yeah, that's what I need.
You need a haircut.
Oh, my God. Ugh.
And, you know, the reason you need a haircut is not because I give a shit, but I'm tired of hearing you complain about
it. It's driving me insane.
You're primming your hair constantly. You're doing this all the time.
I hate it. It's always in the way. You would think, oh, it's back there. No, it's everything I do. It's in the way.
So what I thought we'd talk about a little bit is, first of all, in the timeline of the
we're doing MCU like time travel shit. What are we talking about?
Well, this
about?
Is the SMU time. Quantum? This is the SMU
quantum realm. SMU quantum.
The SMU quantum realm. Okay. Super mega ultra. That's
that's what we do.
SMU FR Smuffer. The Smuffer universe.
This is a Smuff film.
Is oh my God. Anyway, super mega ultra films. It's a Smuff film. We might have just changed the name of our company. So, by this time they will have everyone will have gone out and to watch our short film Manifest that just came out a week ago. Obviously, because people give a shit.
Yeah.
I'm
just waiting for our next thing.
But I thought we'd talk about our feature film, Really Pathetic and Totally Awkward. We just decide. Don't go.
I just forgot that existed, and then you reminded me. Oh yeah, we did that, didn't we?
Ladies and gentlemen, that's the harsh reality. By the time you finally release the thing to YouTube, which is what I want to talk about, you will wish you never made it because you'll be so tired of looking at it, thinking about it, talking about it. Actually, I feel like we're appropriately proud of that film.
Yes.
It isn't the smash hit that anybody thinks they're setting out to make when they first make a film, but it is a solid production from beginning to end. It looks like the same movie in the beginning as it does in the end. It's consistent all the way through. I feel, and I think you feel too, we have solid characters.
Yeah, the writing's good.
The solid writing of characters. The characters is good. Acting's good for the budget and film. It's not like we had Tom Hanks,
No budget.
But we had at least two of the four people we had working on the film with us, the actors, are two of our best friends. So we're proud of them and happy with, but we're ready to move on.
The only reason why I'm like, oh, that thing.
Because we're traumatized.
It's just, I get jealous and I feel like, is there a world where that wasn't actually our first film? And then when we become famous, we have our actual first, like that was for no money and just for, what we could make happen. I want a do-over for our first film so that when we're famous and then everyone's like, doing a, oh man, his first film was blah, blah, blah. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but think about it. If that wasn't our first film, our second film wouldn't be as good because we wouldn't have survived the first film. By the way,
Tarantino jealousy and other, it's his first film. There's people making Marvel movies or whatever, and it's like, oh, it's first film. F you, first film. F you.
By the way, this is the sort of shit that I always feel like should be a Film Reverie episode, and now it gets a chance to be, because this is the real deal on the film. It's like you don't really know how to love your first film because it's your first film. You should be proud of the fact that you did it, because
you're not
honestly,
Scorsese, you're not Quentin Tarantino. You can't
up until that point. Up until the point we made that film, we hadn't made any films. Yeah. Every other feature film we'd ever try, which was one, didn't even get finished.
Yeah, one got stole. Oh, wait, no, that was even a
That
feature.
Was a short film, the short film. Yeah, God, that's I'm still traumatized by that, by losing the footage for that film. But we didn't even get finished. By the way, did you know, you mentioned Quentin Tarantino, did you know that Quentin Tarantino's first film is an incomplete film that people have seen clips of and
Thank
parts
God.
Of? And it is, I don't, I haven't seen it myself, but I've heard people say,
And then yeah, wasn't that a thing, like it was first the play or something, and then he tried to make it into a movie?
No, he made a film.
No, that's Pulp Fiction.
He made a film called My Best Friend's Birthday or something like that. And in there is like his first, it's like his first script. And his first script had a lot of things that we would later see in other Tarantino films.
Right.
But hey, Emma, what you doing? The dog came in. Anyway, in that first film, we'd see a bunch of things that would later become parts of his more successful, more well-formed films.
Yes.
But that film was lost in a fire, in a warehouse fire or something. Some building burned down and his film was in it.
Yeah. So,
and since he didn't get a chance to finish that film, he then sold a couple of screenplays and what was it? True Romance and
my favorite Tarantino film.
Great
movie.
True Romance and what's the one with the Oliver Stone directed? Why can't I think of it? I just
with the shooting.
Yeah, with
bullet,
with the shooting bullet.
The magic bullet. JFK.
No, that's JFK.
Oh.
But he made. Oh my God. Why can't I think of this movie? I'm gonna have to look it up.
Is it a war movie?
No. Why can't I think of it? Anyway.
All he ever did was, whatever you call it, conspiracy theory movies. I don't know. So there's light at the end of the tunnel, that just because they say first, it's not really actually always their first film.
Right, so what
They've
if...
They've made, these people that we look up to have made shit, is what my
Yeah, point. Everybody's, everybody's first film is... Maybe not everybody's,
it's not
but
gold.
It's not solid gold. And people who are listening to our show are screaming at me right now because I can't remember the name of this movie. But I'm just drawing a blank on it.
I know I've seen it.
You've seen it. It's got. I can't even think of his fucking
if
name.
You could think of it.
Oh, Natural Born Killers. That's the movie I'm trying to think of. So he sold Natural Born Killers and True Romance. But just think about it. I was thinking about this the other day. If Tarantino had finished his first film, My Best Friend's Birthday, and it had come out and it had been mediocre and it hadn't been Reservoir Dogs, would he have then gone off and made Reservoir Dogs? Or would he have continued down the mediocre path and eventually landed on Reservoir Dogs?
Would he have gotten the attention?
Right, so...
So, or just in my heart, you know, we still have our first film.
Yeah.
Our first world debut film.
Yeah.
We haven't done it yet.
I mean, that doesn't mean it's going to be our second film. It could be our fucking fifth
film. That's what I'm saying.
And that's the part that traumatizes me.
The film that we present to the world, that what people see, that is what I will consider our first film.
Yeah. So, but what I wanted to talk about... is back to that is do we want to decide right here and now when we're going to release Really Pathetic and Totally Awkward on YouTube so people could watch it for free now that we've spent the last 10 minutes shitting on it. And by the way, we're not shitting on it, but it is the harsh reality of almost like being traumatized by a piece of work that you live with for so long. And at this point, we started making that film in 2016 2017. And it's 2021. It's been done for a while. We let it live on Amazon Prime for a bit. And the plan all along was to put it up on YouTube for people to watch. It should be our first film out.
I think
on...
it needs to be free. We shouldn't... I mean, no one's going to pay.
Well, I mean, we've had a couple... We've had a handful of people pay for it. But that's not... It's not even worried about making money. It's just we want it to be out. We want it to be out.
I want to just get it out there. And also, like... you know, we need to be able to show people, hey, this is what we've done before.
Yeah.
Give us money to make this next
film. Also, when they see our second film, so they can go, holy shit, the same guys made that movie that made this movie. No. Look, I feel like we're shitting on our movie.
It's okay.
Yeah, I feel like we're picking on our redheaded stepchild, and we're not.
It's
we're not.
Fine. It's,
anytime someone goes, it's fine, means it's like,
it's got its good qualities and its bad qualities. It's sort of like you have to like talking movies. You have to be okay with the, a lot of things not happening.
We intentionally set out to make something that could be a play that we would shoot.
Right.
So we had a very, very locked down location. There's one main location in the whole thing. And then there's a couple other scenes that take place in a car and on a park bench and places like that. But it's very chatty. It's very dialogue heavy.
Right.
You could call it a rom-com or dramedy type of thing. So we're talking right now, the day this episode comes out is September 24th.
Okay.
Do we want to say our film will be out on October 1st? That's a week later.
It's so much data I'm trying to process because we're not actually recording on the date that you
said. No. At the time this episode is coming out, it will be September 24th, which is, a couple weeks from now.
Okay.
And
then a week after that?
And the week after that, our film will be out on Friday, October 1st.
Sure.
Sounds good to me. But that's what I think.
We should do a live thing to, usher it in.
Okay.
Or just say, hey, let everyone know.
Yes.
And give a preview.
Yeah.
Like a tease preview. Hey, it's not the greatest thing, but there's
We need to stop saying it like
some
that.
Funny,
it
there's some hilarious shit. If you don't like the first, 5 minutes? The first, that's some good, not even that. No. It's the first 15 minutes is good shit. Come on, you gotta watch at least that part. You might skip out in the middle, but to the beginning is good.
No, well, what we decided a long time ago was that we want Film Reverie to be a place where we actually are open and honest about our stuff. We are not disappointed in our film. We probably would have been more happy about it if it had gone further or blah, blah, blah. You know, the expectations. Expectations, by the way, are where disappointment comes from.
If we had had a budget, we would have been a lot happier.
If we had a budget. But the thing was, it wasn't about having a budget or having money. It was about us saying after several years of trying and false starts, can we do this from beginning to end?
We just said, we're going to make an effing movie. Just forget everything and everyone else. Forget not having any money. Forget we got jobs, whatever. We're making a damn film.
Yeah.
No one's going to stop us. And that's what we did.
And all those false starts. All those false starts. And honestly, at that point, it had been a couple of decades. Because our very first feature film, we started working on in 2001. And we got 90% of it shot. But again, there were budget problems. We didn't have insurance, so we were having trouble finding one location. Well, back in 2001.
It was on digital.
Well, back in 2001, that was acceptable. Even David Lynch was shooting on DV cam back then.
Yeah, that is true.
So, 2001 though, it was, we can't shit on the technology of 2001 because that's what 2001 was.
Yeah.
But we had so many false starts, it took us so much longer to get back. So number one, we jumped off a cliff and tried to build our parachute on the way down. We didn't get the parachute built. Not all of it anyway.
It had some holes.
We got most of it shot.
It's a hard landing.
We got most of it shot, but we had trouble locking down a couple of locations, mostly because I think at the time as a producer, I was even worse than I am now as one. And I was having a hard time figuring out how to make phone calls to just tell people, hey, we're making a movie. Can we shoot in your location? I knew we didn't have insurance, and I let not having insurance stop me from even trying a lot of times. And it prevented us from finishing the movie. That film sat unfinished. It still sits unfinished to this day. It's too late to finish now.
Yeah, because HD and everything.
By the way, we're 1,000 times better storytellers and filmmakers now than we were.
It would be unbearable to try to put that together.
But we did learn a lesson, but that shit camped out in my mind for like 20 years. Eight of those years, I didn't even make anything because I was otherwise occupied. But it camped out in my mind. It's like, it was like, I need to make and finish a film, because the last time we made and finished a film, I had to get the bad taste out of my mouth.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And we did. We went off. We wrote a film. We decided we were going to do it. But we kept having so many false starts, right? That even where for our second film, our Really Pathetic and Totally Awkward, the movie we're talking about, had so many false starts that finally we just had to do the same thing. We're, like you said, we're going to do this. We have to do, we decided to do it no matter what, right? We decided to do it no matter what. I know it bothers you, but
this is a fucking dog.
I know, but let me just tell you something. As the person who edits these episodes, there's always this moment where you complain about the noise that Emma's making, but we can't hear it in the recording.
Oh, okay.
So there's always you going, the dog, and I'm like, what has Brad got?
Edit it out.
But we had so many false starts, and we basically just had to say, we're going to fucking do it. Got to fucking do it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And
no
once,
matter what.
And once we did, we did. And we had a bunch of problems. Sorry, my mom's calling me. I'll have to talk to her later. We had so many problems arise the week before we started shooting, the day before we started shooting, and we had decided in our minds we're doing it anyway. You know? Yeah. Do you remember that?
Yeah, I remember like having conversations with you where I was saying, I don't care if we have to shoot outside or shoot inside scenes outside, if we're in an alleyway, it just, none of it makes any sense. We're trying to watch TV in a trash can. I don't care who we're shooting these scenes. I don't care where or how. We have the actors, we have the cameras, and we're gonna do it.
Yeah. And so honestly, that's the lesson we learned from that, is like, sometimes you just have to do it. The other lesson I learned is, for years and years and years, I would say, look, I don't want to, you know, if we make the film ourselves, we don't have to compromise with anybody. We don't have to adhere to any financing concerns from people giving us money and all that stuff. But ultimately, so what we do have to end up compromising on, though, are things that we would have never compromised on in the first place, like our DP quit the week before we started shooting Really Pathetic and Totally Awkward, and we went with someone else who was a former student of mine, which we were happy to do. He'd already shot a film with us, but what it meant was we lost the camera we were going to get to shoot on. We shot on 1080 instead of 4K and all that, so we had to compromise. We had compromised on something that we never would have had to compromise on if we just had a budget. You know what I mean? So, but anyway, so October 1st, our film will come. Our film, Really Pathetic and Total Arc, and we're saying it here now, so we can't put it off another week, like we have been doing for basically about a month. We've been talking about putting it on for a couple months. We've been talking about just putting it out, and we keep not picking a date.
It got to the point where I was convinced we already did put it out.
Yeah, well, it's out. I just wanted to let it live on Prime for a little bit. And we were going to unlock it on Prime, but Amazon does this thing now where they pull some films, that a bunch of films, like indie films that don't get a lot of traction. Mm-hmm. They're not getting like Steven Spielberg numbers, so they like pull them off the platform.
Mm-hmm.
So I was going to do Prime and YouTube and wherever else we could get it on, but for now we're just going to do YouTube. On our website. So you'll be able to find our film on our website at smuentertainment.com, and then click on projects and the film will be right there.
I'm going to work on upgrading our website.
You heard it here.
In a convenient, efficient way. I don't want to turn into the website technician.
No, no, no.
That's all I do all the time.
I think... You're more worried about that than we really need to, because you, like me and like other people we know, say, we need a website, and then suddenly it turns into, and then weekly, and every other day we could have this new thing come out, and it gets turned into this big, huge production. But if we just had a place, like we do now, but we don't really, we're not in love with our website, but like we do now, we have a place that just sits there, and when we have a project, we can post it there, and that's what it is. You just make one little update every now and then.
You're simplifying it. There's all these rules of having things on the internet that are enforced on you when you try to do it manually. That's what I hate.
We have things on the internet right now. I'm not following.
That's what I'm saying.
I'm not following anybody's rules.
Yeah, because Google, just trust me. It's all this and behind the scenes stuff. If you don't do it, then your website is like not secure, and then the browser, when people go, the browser says this website isn't secure, and then they're like, okay, and then they don't go there. And
yeah, but we had that problem solved too.
Yeah,
but back before the GoDaddy store.
I don't
want
to get into it, but doing website through WordPress by yourself is
I don't
want to
do it in
work.
WordPress. I don't want to do WordPress.
Right, that's what I'm talking about. I'd rather find something that lets you do it. You know, it does most of the work, and you don't have to worry about like viruses and attacks and all this stuff.
Is this...
You know, did I update the plugin? Did I download all the backups and fucking update all the middlemen?
Is this your new version of trying to do voices? Because you can stop now.
It's not working.
So that's it. Hey,
anyway.
Hey. So
websites.
We have, I think we can wrap it up for today. We good?
Sure.
And oh, and by now, everyone will have seen our short film Manifest, right? Correct?
I thought this episode was going to be about Manifest.
No, it's even though we talked about it beforehand, already. Yeah. Manifest came out last week on our website. And it's free for everybody to use. It's our short film. It's probably the most hopeful film we'd ever made.
It's PG, right?
Yeah, I'd say PG-13. There's a PG-13 moment.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's our most PG film to date ever. We gotta cut that shit out. We gotta get back to the motherfuckers.
We can actually tell people about this one.
There's where you and I differ. I tell people about my film anyway. I don't want to say it this way. Both my grandmothers are gone. I have no grandparents to be disappointed in me if they saw my film.
And you've already ruined your parents.
My parents have seen all my stuff reluctantly, I'm sure. So, you know, my
it's
preacher.
It's just me.
It's just you. Yeah. Yeah, but I've also gotten used to the shame by, like, when I go out in public with you, I just got used to feeling like people are looking at me weird. I just got used to it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, well, at least I'm doing some good in the world.
Yeah. You made me a better man.
You made me one, yeah.
All right, well, that's it for this time. Hey, follow us on Instagram, Twitter. I'm Becca Meyer, Balding Ewok.
Speaking of that, out of context quotes on TikTok.
Oh, yeah, we have out of context quotes on TikTok.
We got to do that one.
Yeah, we got to do that one.
You make me be a better man.
Basically, if you go on TikTok and you follow Super Mega Ultra, we only have a couple of videos up there right now, but two of them that are up there are out of context movie quotes where we just pick famous movie lines from movies and say them in other ways. Like we did Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker, but we screamed it like we were angry. Brad did a drunk version of it.
I did a terrible sexy version.
And what was the other one we did?
Where we're going.
We don't need roads. And we did the line from Back to the Future.
We don't need roads. Yeah.
Roads, where we're going, we don't need roads. We did a version where we were screaming it, yelling it.
Yeah.
Where we're laughing hysterically at it. It's, anyway.
We're ruining it by explaining it.
Yeah, you shouldn't be explaining your own jokes.
It's funny when you see it.
But
and we'll be doing more.
Yeah, yeah. We thought it would be fun to do something like that. Anyway. If you like weird shit, it's definitely weird. Yeah. Anyway, so that's Super Mega Ultra on TikTok and our Discord, which is look it up again.
Our Discord is where we're sending everybody. We're gonna do all of our stuff on Discord. There's too many social media things here and there. Just we're gonna be on Discord. Come join us on Discord. That's where we're gonna have everyone.
Finest Super Mega Ultra hashtag 7516.
Yeah, and also if on Discord is where we will eventually make it to where maybe people could fans could join us on the show.
Yeah, on the show.
We could
yeah.
just give you the link. You can pop on and be on the show. Like
there you go.
Anytime. Like
anytime.
Right now.
Anytime.
Click a button.
Yeah. Well, that's it.
Yep.
That's it for this time. Hey, we hope you're enjoying our Friday episodes. I'm having fun. Sitting down and just talking about just, you know.
Yeah.
The filmmaking stuff.
It's been a while.
And now what I've figured out how to do is I can have a meeting with you and record it. And we're getting a show and a meeting. So I can leave now. We don't have to.
Working smarter, not harder.
Yeah. I don't have to then hang around with you and have another infuriating meeting. Now in front of the microphone, we can have the meeting and we can make it ha 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 ha. And I'm like, okay, that's the meeting. See you later.
We sort of have like half-assed meetings like from here to the theater.
Yeah.
And then like I start getting frustrated about something you're talking about because I can't wrap my head around it. Yeah. And then I'm like, oh, I can't do it. And then you get pissed off and walk away faster than me. And I'm like, I think he's a little upset, pretending not to be.
It's like you just described my life back to me. All right, that's it. All right, see you next time.
And bye.
Cut.
The end. God.
Film Reverie Podcast is a production of Super Mega Ultra Entertainment and is produced by Michael Beckemeyer and Bradley Kingston. If you're enjoying this podcast, please be sure to leave us a 5-star review in iTunes and be sure to click like or subscribe wherever you find us. That's it for this time. We'll see you again next week with another episode of Film Reverie.